Hello everyone, Narcissist almost here, and recently people have been talking about the misuse of the word narcissist. That is, people calling other people narcissists when they're really not. Perhaps the person is being a jerk or obnoxious or misbehaving in a way that the other person doesn't like. So I thought I'd address what they call a true blue pathological narcissist versus someone who just has a narcissistic personality style. So most of us here are familiar with the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual, or DSM, and their criteria to be met to qualify as someone with Narcissistic Personality Disorder, or NPD. But in case you need a reminder, once someone has met with a psychiatrist, they must meet 5 of the following 9 criteria. So, you have the grandiose logic of self-importance, a fixation with fantasies of infinite success, control, brilliance, beauty, or idyllic love, a credence that he or she is extraordinary and exceptional and can only be understood by or should connect with other extraordinary or important people or institutions, a desire for unwarranted admiration, a sense of entitlement, interpersonally oppressive behavior or exploitative, no empathy, resentment of others or conviction that others are resentful of him or her, and a display of egotistical and conceited behaviors or attitudes. Sounds simple enough, right? Well, it's not. Not only would you really have to know the person you're diagnosing, you'd also have to know when they're lying, performing, or manipulating you. Even then, the criteria is kind of vague, in my opinion, and so, as far as I'm concerned, you'd really have to be a very good psychiatrist or a psychic, you know? Next is your layman's diagnosis, or rather your armchair psychologist, who is convinced that someone is a narcissist because someone might have offended them, lied to them, cheated on them, or stole from them. Sorry to say, all those types of behavior in isolation does not a narcissist make. Because someone may have used you, talked behind your back, or dumped you doesn't mean they're a narcissist. Hardly at all. So throwing around the word narcissist is not helpful, and it dilutes the true meaning. I like to use the word narcissist when I'm referring to a pathological narcissist. I often use the word pathological, but because it's a little clumsy, I leave it out. So when I'm talking about a narcissist, or pathological narcissist, to be more precise, I'm definitely talking about someone with narcissistic personality disorder, that is, someone who meets all the DSM's criteria and then some. But there are people referring to others as narcissists who are not. They simply may be a liar, or cheater, or greedy, etc. For example, someone who is a serial cheater might be a sex addict. That's not making excuses for them, but that might be the problem, their only problem. Or someone who is a workaholic and is never home for their family might just be only that one thing, a workaholic, not a narcissist. Then there are people who have a type of personality style that is gregarious, flashy, or the opposite, depressed and pouty. That's just how they express themselves in the world, and it could be nothing more than that. Someone may not like this about them, but it doesn't make them a narcissist. I think you get the idea. And then there is the words, narcissism and narcissistic. And when used in the right context, these can be helpful. As you know, we all have a degree of narcissism. In fact, it's necessary for a healthy psychology. But you could describe someone who has too much narcissism as being kind of a jerk, and not imply they're a narcissist. Finally, there is narcissistic, and I use this from time to describe someone who is tipping the scales of narcissism and someone who I might suspect could be a narcissist, but don't know them enough to say one way or another. Finally, there is a spectrum, as you all know, and most of you are familiar with it. The one I use is according to my favorite psychiatrist on personality disorders, and that is Dr. Otto Kernberg. I tried to simplify it here, and it starts with neuroticism ascending in severity to psychotic. So you can have your classic narcissist, which most people are familiar with, to your malignant narcissist, which is rare, or so the experts say, but are much, much more dangerous. And you'll find those somewhere in the middle. The malignant narcissist, of course, will be nearer to psychopathy or the psychopath. So you will not know for sure if someone's a true blue pathological narcissist until it's too late, I'm sorry to say. Someone who is pathological has been wired this way their entire life. They know it's wrong, abnormal, and sometimes criminal, but they don't care. They really don't have a conscience, so to speak, a morality, although they will claim to be moral and sit on their high horse, but they're really not. They lie to themselves, believing that this way of thinking is actually exceptional and makes them special, above the maddening crowd, as Sam Beckman would say. They truly do believe they are better than you, smarter than you, and therefore they are entitled to everything they want, and of course everything they do is perfect and nothing is their fault. Because they've never developed empathy, they are capable of doing anything to anyone. But most are aware of societal limits, so they have to hide their dirty deeds. The mask of normalcy they've crafted since early childhood is meant for them to fit into society, and you won't see the real person until you're behind closed doors and they're sure they can get away with their abuse. It must remain secret because their image is everything, and for some, it's the only thing that matters. So trying to expose them could be a deadly venture. To live with a pathological narcissist is like living in a horror film or a nightmare you can't wake up from. As time goes by, the narc will do and say things that make no sense, mostly because they're living in a different reality or fantasy land where you're just a prop for them to exploit. You mean nothing to them except for what you can do for them. Someone this disturbed will make you physically ill eventually and even suicidal. It's a creeping, painfully slow process of discovery. That is, discovering that your chosen partner is deeply disturbed, incapable of anything. Each and every day you are Sisyphus, pushing the boulder up the hill only for it to fall back to the bottom at the end of the day, accomplishing nothing in relational terms with the narcissist. The pathological narcissist is a con man, an actor, with no internal life, so devoid of humanity you can hardly believe your eyes once you see it. You start to see a spoiled child bully who is greedy, exploitative, manipulative, and will do anything to get what they think they deserve, and they think they deserve everything. I'm not kidding at all. I've seen it. You soon realize that everything about their contrived image is fake, and once you see this, they will throw you away and without a care in the world. They need to get rid of you, basically discard you, smear you, throw you away because you might expose them. It's like throwing away the evidence of their crimes. They have no conscience and will sleep like a baby at night when they do this. To see this in the pathological narcissist can't be unseen and can only be described as evil. It's like sickening. Once you realize what you've been with, you actually want to take a lot of showers. Let me put it that way. Take it from me, someone who used to believe that there was good in everyone, and given the right opportunities, kindness, and care, they could thrive. I never believed in the death penalty either. In fact, I didn't understand it. But now that I've experienced a malignant narcissist, I no longer believe in people, and have no problem with the death penalty. The narc did that. My whole reality was turned upside down and was corrupted to an extent. He single-handedly ripped off my rose-colored glasses and took away my faith in humanity. I now understand how things like Nazi Germany happened when neighbor turned against neighbor. Once you've had this most unfortunate experience of a narcissist, nothing will ever be the same. Nothing. I promise you. So there's a big difference between someone being a jerk and someone like a pathological narcissist who is so deeply disturbed. There is no one and nothing that can help them. The only thing you can do is save yourself.